god of light.
American Northwest beauty spot, and we're camping over there in the trees, and we're surrounded by redwoods and birds singing, and where the Columbia River meets the Pacific in this beautiful, wild, misty place, full of crows and cormorants, and it's very pretty. We have just reached our first corner of America, and it's Cape Flattery in Washington. It's also David's first flight into Washington, and it's absolutely the most beautiful place, very wild, it's a bit rainy.
Flying through the most magnificent mountains that one could see. Beautiful clear blue day, everything went well. But as you can see in a minute from this hotel room, it's kind of like being in some sort of B-grade movie. And this is the best that Oroville has to offer. So have a look.
We are in Glacier National Park. We've just done a short hike up to a fantastic lake. I think there are about six or seven waterfalls, and a chipmunk just run under my foot, and the birds are singing yet again. We are in a hidden lake in Glacier. We crossed snow-filled crevasses and risked our lives to get here. Many glaciers on our way up to a glacier, and it's very beautiful, loads of wildflowers, beautiful views. We just saw a moose, and we may see a bear. Arrived in Yellowstone, and we're at the geysers, summer geysers. Very beautiful. State Park, and we followed the Little Devil Trail up to Harney Peak, and there's incredible granite everywhere, and again, an incredibly beautiful place. By how beautiful, again, I feel like I can't come up with any other line everywhere we go, because everywhere has been so beautiful.
Momentous occasion, because we are now headed south. We've reached our easternmost point of our journey, and from now on we're going to be hitting the big city and all that that has to offer.
We just climbed up the Beehive Trail. We're in Acadia Park, and again, it's a stunning place, and it's wonderful to be hiking here. We are in Newport, Rhode Island, walking along the cliff walk past mansions that look like they came out of the Great Gatsby, and it's a fantastic warm day with a sea breeze. And
that I love. Have I told you there's no one?
This is where the Constitution and everything was signed, just back there actually, in that building over there. So, it was fun. Here at the Franklin Delano Roosevelt Memorial, and you can see the guy behind us. Rights Memorial in Kitty Hawk, which is the place where the first flight took place.
We are on the Appalachian Trail in the Smoky Mountains on the very border of Tennessee, North Carolina. I don't know which state we're in, actually. And there are bears. On the river walk in San Antonio, Texas, and it's very pretty, a little bit of a smelly river, but it's very cute and humid, and this is it. We've just landed in Alpine, Texas, and our flight hopefully was one of the last difficult decision flights we've had to make to escape from the hurricanes, because that we were flying into a potentially not so good weather situation at Alpine. But actually it was fine. David did a fantastic job and I just gripped the seat and held on. The Rio Grande, Texas, and because of the hurricanes and rain and thunderstorms, it is flooded, more flooded than it's been since 1970 something.
We are on a scenic drive through the Big Bend mountains, basically, and we're at a place called the Sotol Vista.
Tombstone, Arizona. We landed in an almost dirt strip with nothing, and now we're here at the Wild Wild West. We're in prison now in Yuma, in an old prison, like an Alcatraz, but it's a museum. We didn't do anything wrong. And behind us is the Colorado River, or what's left of it at this point in the boiling hot desert. We've landed in California. We are in California. Our first stop immediately after landing the plane was heading to the wineries in the Inland Empire. So here we are.